Can you tell me your name?
Wyatt.
Oh, yeah. How old are you?
Six.
Who's your favorite sister in the world?
She's always right.
Here, any second.
Wait, Mrs. Socrates.
I know. But that's, you know.
I'm missing half of one.
I know.
Left of Haney's company braced for the assault they assumed would come at dawn.
I was laying there on the perimeter right next to a dead enemy soldier. Was kind of my face and his feet, and I kept looking back at him. I couldn't see any wounds on him. This guy's gonna kill me. He's faking it. He's waiting until the assault is gonna jump up and kill me. And I almost shot him again. Just to make sure he was dead.
Then the enemy began to lob mortar shells among Haney's men.
I felt like somebody had taken a bat and hit me on my calf as hard as he could. I was so stunned by the shock of being hit, and I just saw him. Terrible pain. I couldn't speak. Right after the ambush happened, I knew I'd lost a bunch of guys. I said a prayer to God, saying, basically, if you need any more guys from my platoon, take me. Don't take any more of my men. As soon as I said it, I freaked myself out. I was like, holy shit. Can I take that prayer back? But it was too late. I said it. And as it turns out,
American artillery finally zeroed in on the enemy. The survivors of Haney's company stumbled down the hill to safety. He was carried to a hospital.
Oh, but you couldn't make me one?
I know my dad. Sorry.
But it was all the...
Where's
this piece of come from?
And at that point, platoons are huge. One guy from Detroit, I loved his son, Sam. He came over and sat down next to me. I said, hey, he said to this nurse, man, this is my kind of thing.
Thank you.
Chewie suddenly fired the driver, Jim, a popular Buddhist man. Demonstrators poured into the streets to wail and demand. They shut down the port to which U.S. supplies had been flooded. Some South Vietnamese soldiers, loyal to the dismissed general, abandoned the stolen lands to communists and headed for the city. Angry crowds burned American jeeps. Signs reading peace. Johnson was so concerned, he asked his advisors to break. instruments that harbored copperheads and cottonmouths. Had to learn how to detect booby traps and outmaneuver veterans masquerading as vehicles. Expect the unexpected, Beckwith told his trainees again and again. Life is unfair. Once he'd become a ranger, Harrison was eager to get to Vietnam and put into action the survival and leadership skills he'd been absorbing for 5 years.
I remember discussing with my classmates how horrible it would be to serve in the Army if everybody just a year ahead of us had served in combat and we didn't have the opportunity to do that. I was afraid we would win the war too quickly and I wouldn't have a chance to experience it.
Was Moggy Crocker's 19th birthday. His company was involved in yet another campaign aimed at finding and killing North Vietnamese troops filtering into the Central Islands from Laos. As night fell, Moggy and his squad were ordered to move up toward the crest of a hill overlooking a besieged Arvin outpost so that artillery could be brought and positioned to shell the enemy in the morning. They moved slowly, warily up the slope. Moggy was the point man. Out of the darkness, a machine gun opened up. Denton Crocker Jr. never made it to the top of the hill.
Thank you.
Catholic priest had
suggested
Mugi be buried in Saratoga Springs so that his parents could easily visit his grave. Many bombs hit their intended targets, but many missed and fell on residential neighborhoods instead, just as the president had feared.
Take that. They got some good stuff out there.